Hey everyone, Ricky here from Ricky's Tech Talk. Today I want to show you a simple step-by-step guide on how to set up your brand new Oppo device. So I will be using the Oppo Find X5 Pro 5G. Thank you to Vodafone who supplied this device to the channel. So the setup process is relatively easy and simple, but sometimes there are some hurdles and I want to show you today how I can help. So the power button is down the right hand side. It's tactilely different and has a green bar running along it. Tap the green arrow to begin the setup process. Our first option is to select our language. But before I begin, I want to just highlight there are some accessible settings that you can change here at the beginning. So on the top right hand corner, there is an accessible icon that you can press. So tapping this icon will load into an accessible settings menu. Select this and that turns on the options. Our first option is tap to zoom. So toggle this on and then tap three times quickly on the display. And as you can see, that jumps in and out and magnifies very quickly for you. Our next option is select to speak.
Welcome to TalkBack. Welcome to TalkBack. Page 1 of 5, TalkBack is a screen reader intended for situations or people who have difficulty seeing.
As you can hear, this narrates everything back to you, making it really easy to use your device. Then finally, we have the ability to turn on high contrast colours to help. So coming back, let's go through the setup process now. So as I mentioned, the first option is to select your language. We're choosing English. Then you're asked to select your region, so United Kingdom. Then we have legal information, terms and conditions. You can tick the bottom option and select next. Then you have the option to insert your SIM card. So thank you to Vodafone UK. We've already got a SIM card inserted, but it goes in the bottom left-hand corner and we're going to hit next. Then you're going to be asked to choose your Wi-Fi network. So find your Wi-Fi network on here and enter your password. Once you've connected, it will say connected and you can press next. Then it's going to check for software updates. Then it will ask you if you want to copy apps and data. This is where you can use the tool to copy from an old phone to new phone, but we're not going to do that. The next step is to sign into your Google account or create a Google account. This is so you can use all of its apps and services. Once signed in, you'll have terms and conditions to agree to from Google. You can read through these or you can hit next at the bottom. It's up to you. It's worth reading through at least once. It's quite long though. So tapping next, we've got then some more agreements. We're going to hit next again. It moves on to share all the Google services that you can agree to and choose to use, such as backup, photos, and other services from Google. So select the ones you want, tap next. Then it gives you a list of additional applications you can install, such as Vodafone, TikTok, and other social medias. So press OK. Then it comes on to navigation. So you have navigation via gesture or navigation by controls, the back, home, and menu option. So it's up to you which one you prefer to choose. And if you haven't used a smartphone before, maybe the button option. Then it moves on to unlock options. So I'm going to choose the fingerprint. So it has an inbuilt fingerprint, which is optical. This is where you place your finger on the display and you do need to add a backup code. Once you put in your backup code, a new display will come up where it asks you to put your finger or your thumb on your display and there's a fingerprint pattern that you need to fill in. So it will start with the larger part of your finger and then ask you to fill in the edges. You can also add other fingers if you want to or other thumbs, so making it really easy and simple to unlock your display, or you could use face unlock as well if you wanted to. So hit next and then it says welcome. And you can press get started and that is the setup process complete. So this device is running Android 12, which is the latest version. And then Oppo have their own version, which they put on top, so a skin, which is called Color OS. So I can explain a lot more about that in future videos. I hope this simple step-by-step setup process has helped you set up your brand new Oppo device. If it is the Find X5 Pro, let me know what you think. It's always great to hear from you. If you do need any help or support though, please leave a comment below and I'd be very happy to help. From me, Ricky, thank you for watching and supporting the channel. Make sure if you haven't already to hit subscribe, ring that notification bell to stay updated when I release new videos. Have a great day and I will see you in my next video. Bye for now. If you wish to see more of my videos, check these out here on the left-hand side. And as I mentioned, make sure to subscribe by clicking on my face here on the right-hand side. Always leave a comment below just underneath that like button. It's always great to hear from you.